Now to a News 4 exclusive. At the White House today, President Barack Obama talked about creating jobs outside the cities of America. News 4's Michael Cogdill was there to speak with the president one-on-one. He has more tonight from the West Wing.
Well, good evening from the White House briefing room, where President Barack Obama, right around the corner there through that door, granted myself and several other select reporters from around the country one-on-one interviews today. Reporters don't get behind the walls here very, very often. But today in the cabinet room, he talked about his rural initiative, a plan to create jobs and generate new infrastructure for small businesses around the country.
Last summer, I had a rural summit, and we talked about the need for small businesses to get financing. And we set a goal that we now have actually exceeded in terms of putting millions of dollars into small businesses in rural communities for things like clean energy projects, various initiatives on food processing. And there is a big opportunity for small and medium-sized businesses to locate and to take root in these rural communities that can help relieve unemployment and build on the success of the farm economy.
Some of the economists don't like it. It's not that they don't like it, but they're sort of saying ho-hum. Robert Reich called it policy miniature. What do you say to them, the critics who are already
I think that what we've seen coming out of the worst recession since the Great Depression is that in slow increments, us being able to make progress, whether it's in the auto industry or in clean energy or in the rural economy, all these things add up to a more robust economy. And an economy that's built to last, that's not just built on financial speculation, that's not just built on a housing bubble that ultimately bursts, but it is really built from the bottom up.
The president also talked with me today about gridlock on Capitol Hill. I had mentioned a couple of key names from South Carolina's not-so-distant past. Strom Thurmond and Fritz Hollings, ideological opposites. They couldn't be more different, and yet they seem to care about each other and get along and cooperate, and that wasn't that long ago.
Right.
Mr. President, what happened on Capitol Hill, and how do we get back to the sort of that gentleman, gentlelady spirit of esprit de corps?
I tell you what, Congress obviously is in a polarized mood right now. Part of it has to do with the fact that both sides, but especially in the Republican Party, what you've seen is the more extreme wing is challenging more moderate members in primaries, and that makes everybody nervous. And so you've seen a couple of moderate Republicans, even most recently Dick Lugar out of Indiana, getting beat by Tea Party challengers, and that, I think, makes it more difficult for them to cooperate across party lines.
And you never know who you're going to run into around the White House. Today, we bumped into Betty White, who came by to see the president and get in a visit also with the Obama's dog, Bo. And we got our own visit with Bo as well, right there on the South Lawn. Proving the White House is a place of serious history, serious business, that tries not to take itself too seriously. At the White House, Michael Cogdill, WYFF, News 4.
And tomorrow night, more from Michael on his visit to the White House, including some lighthearted moments with President Obama. That's tomorrow at 5 p.m. right here on News 4.